We're going to take a look at how to nest some squares and rectangles using FastCUT 6. We're going to start our program. Once our program started, we're going to put in some job information, such as the job number, the customer. And all this information is optional, but it will show up on the reports. The description of our material is going to be 1/8 inch sheet, and our thickness is going to be 1/8 inch. Go over to our parts list. Over here you can type in the size and name of your parts, or you can use a Control C to copy and Control V to paste out of a spreadsheet like Excel. I've already went ahead and copied mine, pasted mine in there. The next tab over is going to be our machine parameters. If you'd like to add kerf or you have machine limitations, you can put those in here. Control C, copy. Click in my cell, Control V to paste my different quantities of material, width and length in my different locations. Once I have that in there, I'm going to go over to the rates and I'm going to put some pricing in here. It's going to be $69.95 a pound, and then we're going to charge 55 cents a pound for processing. And click our optimize button. I'm going to optimize on cost. I'm going to set this to automatically stop after 2,500 trials, which should be more than enough for this. It's going to go through and it's going to optimize my material for me. Try to get the best possible cuts. Now we're at our 2,500 trials. It gives me a summary of the number of plates from each location that I'm going to use, showing me that all my parts are optimized. It's going to give me a cutting list showing me my stock and what I'm going to cut out of each piece of stock. It's going to give me my cost table, which is going to use the price per pound that I put in and give me a total for this job. And then I can double click on this picture down here and we can actually look at the patterns for how the material is going to be cut. And that's how you optimize squares and rectangles using FastCut 6.